Shuklambaradharam Vishnum Shashivarnam Chaturbhujam Prasannavadanam Dhyayet Sarva Vigno Pashantaye Ramaya Ramabhadraya Ramachandraya Vedhase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pataye Namaha Om. Dear friends, we are seeing the first chapter of Valmiki Ramayana, the first chapter of the first book, which is known as the Samkshepa Ramayana. That is, Samkshepa means the summary of Ramayana as told by Narada to Valmiki. And I am reading out all the 100 shlokas because some people may be interested in learning, because the children usually they learn this, the whole passage by heart. So now in the last episode, I was reading the 70th shloka, 70, shloka number 70. Tato grudhrasya vachanat sampater hanuman bali shatayojana vistirnam pupluve lavanarnavam. We know the story of Hanuman. Hanuman doesn't know his own strength, and somebody has to remind him of his strength, because it so happened that in his childhood, when Hanuman was still young, Hanuman wanted to capture the sun himself, and in that process he got slightly injured also, and then he was doing all the such mighty things. So then the gods told he they just said, okay, let this man not know his own strength. So though this man was having all strength, Hanuman, you see, Hanuman was born of the amsha of Shiva and a very mighty man, but then he did not know his own strength. Somebody has to remind him of his strength. So what happens is, there is a person called Jambavan, an elderly man. So he reminds him of his strength. You see, you are born of this Shiva Samsha and you have this great strength. I can only fly only up to some 70 yojanas. Angada says, okay, I can fly up to only about 90 yojanas. Somebody else says, no, I can just cross, but then I may not be able to come back. So that is how they keep on discussing. Hanuman is just sitting in a corner and then he is not saying anything. Then Jambavan says, you see, our Hanuman is the man who is capable of doing all this. So they just tell him, you are capable. Then Hanuman realizes, yes, I am capable. Then he grows in size, and then from that hill called Mahendragiri, he jumps on to the, he takes a jump, and then how he jumps, and then that particular sarga is again a very long sarga there in Sundarakanda, the very first sarga, because many people, they do Parayanam of Sundarakanda, and in that Parayanam, you come across a beautiful passage, that is the very first passage, which describes the passage of Hanuman over the sea. A few miles, we do not know how many miles, shata yojana vistirnam, 100 yojanas, that means obviously a few miles, vistirnam, pupluve lavanarnavam, he flew over that. Then tatra lankam samasadhya purim ravanapalitam, dadarsha sitam dhyayantim ashokavanikam gatam. Very, very briefly, Narada is telling the story. Tatra Lankam Samasadhya, having reached this Lanka, Purim Ravana Palitam, that city which was ruled by Ravana. Ravana, the meaning of Ravana is Ravayati, that is, he makes people cry. Rama is Ramayati, Ramayati iti Rama, that is, by his great virtues, he makes people happy. And Ramante Yoginaha Yasmin, all these yogis, saints and all these people, they take delight in the name of Rama. Whereas Ravana is somebody who makes people cry. So Ravana, Ravana Palitam. But as I was saying, Ravana is a demon, no doubt, but then he is son of Pulastya Muni. So Ravana is a Brahmana. In fact, I am making this point just to emphasize that we should not think that it is a fight between some Aryan and Dravidian people. So, and Ravana, the description of kingdom, this description of Lanka, you find in lot many houses there is Veda Ghosha. Lot many people are chanting this Vedas in that Lanka. And Hanuman searches every house. Dadarsha Sitam Dhyayantim, and then he saw Sita. Where? Ashokavanikam Gatam, in that Ashokavana, he saw that Sita. Dhyayanti, she was just, she was absorbed in thought, we can say. Or she was meditating. Dhyayanti, dhyanam, dhyanam, it can be anything. Dhyanam is absorbed in meditation, we can say, absorbed in deep thought, we can say. So she was in just deep thought. When we see Sundarakanda, she was engaged in deep thought, because she was just trying to know, what exactly is happening to me? Will this news that I am staying here, will this news ever reach Rama? Will he be able to ever come? So she is in that great dilemma. దెన్ నివేదయిత్వాభిజ్ఞానం ప్రవృత్తించ నివేద్య చ సమాశ్వాస్య చ వైదేహీం మర్దయామాస తోరణం. సో దెన్ హీ ఇంట్రడ్యూస్డ్ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్, నివేదయిత్వా అభిజ్ఞానం. అభిజ్ఞానం మీన్స్ దట్ మార్క్ ఆఫ్ ఐడెంటిఫికేషన్. అండ్ వితౌట్ దట్ మార్క్ ఆఫ్ ఐడెంటిఫికేషన్ సీత వుడ్ నాట్ బి ఏబుల్ టు నో దట్ దిస్ జెంటిల్మన్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ సెంట్ బై రామ, బికాస్ వీ డోంట్ దే డి నాట్ హ్యావ్ ఎనీ ఐడి కార్డ్స్ ఆర్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఇన్ దోస్ డేస్. ఆబ్వియస్లీ హీ హ్యాడ్ నో ఐడెంటిటీ, నో ఐడి కార్డ్స్, నో మెసేజ్, నో ఈమెయిల్, నథింగ్ దట్ సో అండ్ సో ఈస్ కమింగ్ ఎట్సెట్రా. సో న్యాచురల్లీ దెర్ వాజ్ అన్ అభిజ్ఞానం. రామ హ్యాడ్ గివన్ హిజ్ అంగులి టు సే హనుమాన్. సో హీ క్యారీస్ దిస్ సే అంగులి, హీ ప్రెజెంట్స్ దట్ అంగులి, ద అంగులీయకం. అంగులీయకం మీన్స్ అంగులి ఈజ్ ఫింగర్, అంగులీయకం ఈజ్ దట్ రింగ్. సో హీ ప్రెజెంట్స్ దట్ అభిజ్ఞానం. అభిజ్ఞానం ఈజ్ మార్క్ ఆఫ్ ఐడెంటిఫికేషన్. హీ టెల్స్ ది ఎంటైర్ స్టోరీ. అండ్ సమాశ్వాస్య చ వైదేహీం, హీ కన్సోల్స్ వైదేహి, నో డోంట్ వరీ, రామ ఈజ్ గోయింగ్ టు కమ్, డెఫినెట్లీ హీ విల్ ష్యూర్లీ కమ్, అండ్ వీ నో ద స్ట్రెంగ్త్ ఆఫ్ రామ, హీ విల్ ష్యూర్లీ సే కాంకర్ దీస్ పీపుల్ అండ్ దెన్ టేక్ యూ బ్యాక్. దెన్ మర్దయామాస తోరణం, హీ ఆల్సో బ్రోక్ దట్ పర్టిక్యులర్ ఆర్చ్. దేర్ వాజ్ ఎన్ ఆర్చ్, హ్యూజ్ ఆర్చ్ ఫర్ దట్ సే గార్డెన్ అశోకవన. సో వై డిడ్ యూ డూ దట్? యూజువల్లీ వీఆర్ అండర్ ద ఇంప్రెషన్ దట్ ఓకే, హీ వెంట్ దేర్ అండ్ దెన్ హీ కన్వేడ్ ద మెసేజ్ ఫర్ సమ్ రీజన్, హీ జస్ట్ సే డ్యామేజ్డ్ ది ఆర్ డిస్ట్రాయిడ్ ది తోరణం. బట్ యాజ్ వీ సీ ఇన్ సే సుందరకాండ, హనుమాన్ ఈజ్ అ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంటెలిజెంట్ క్యారెక్టర్. హీ ఈజ్ నాట్ మియర్లీ ఎ మైటీ మ్యాన్, హీ ఈజ్ అ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంటెలిజెంట్ మినిస్టర్, వెరీ థాట్ఫుల్ మినిస్టర్. హిజ్ ఐడియా వాస్ నో ద ఎనిమీ, హౌ టు నో ది స్ట్రెంగ్త్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎనిమీ. దెర్ ఈజ్ ఎ సేయింగ్ ఇన్ వార్ఫేర్ ఫర్ యు నో వెన్ యూ గో ఫర్ ఎ వార్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు నో ది స్ట్రెంగ్త్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎనిమీ, నో ద ఎనిమీ ఇట్ సేస్. సో హనుమాన్ వాస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫస్ట్ మ్యాన్ హూ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంటెడ్ దట్ నో ద ఎనిమీ రూల్. సో ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు నో ది స్ట్రెంగ్త్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎనిమీ యూ హ్యావ్ టు పికప్ సమ్ ఫైట్. సో హౌ టు పికప్ ద ఫైట్? అండ్ ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ హీ థింక్స్, విల్ ఇట్ బి పాసిబుల్ టు కన్విన్స్ దీస్ పీపుల్? సామ్ దేర్ ఆర్ ఫోర్ వేస్ ఆఫ్ వినింగ్ ఓవర్ ఆర్ వినింగ్ సే యువర్ ఆబ్జెక్టివ్. వాట్ ఆర్ దోస్ ఫోర్ వేస్? సామ, దాన, భేద అండ్ దండ. సామ మీన్స్ సిట్ ఆన్ ఎ టేబుల్, యూ హ్యావ్ నెగోసియేషన్ అండ్ ట్రై టు రీజన్ విత్ దెమ్ అండ్ దెన్ ట్రై టు గెట్ ది వాట్ ఈస్ డ్యూ టు యూ, దట్ ఈస్ సామ. దాన మీన్స్ యూ సరెండర్ సంథింగ్, యూ గివ్ సమ్ మనీ, యూ సరెండర్ సంథింగ్, ఈల్డ్ టు సమ్ ఎక్స్టెంట్ అండ్ దెన్ యూ టేక్ గెట్ బ్యాక్ వాట్ యూ వాంట్. దెన్ భేద, భేద ఈజ్ క్రియేటింగ్ సమ్ ఇంటర్నల్ డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ది ఎనిమీ ఇన్ ది ఎనిమీ క్యాంప్ అండ్ దెన్ ట్రై టు విన్ ఓవర్ సమ్ పీపుల్ అండ్ దెన్ గెట్ వాట్ యూ వాంట్, దట్ ఈస్ భేద. దండ మీన్స్ వెన్ ఆల్ దీస్ త్రీ, వెన్ ద ఆల్ దీస్ ద ఫస్ట్ త్రీ స్ట్రాటజీస్ ఫెయిల్, ద లాస్ట్ స్ట్రాటజీ ఈజ్ దండ. యూ హ్యావ్ నో అదర్ ఆప్షన్ బట్ టు వేజ్ వార్. సో హనుమాన్ డెలిబరేట్స్ అట్ ద టైమ్, యూ సీ, ఈజ్ ఇట్ పాసిబుల్ టు అచీవ్ మై ఆబ్జెక్టివ్ ఇన్ సామ? ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ పాసిబుల్ బికాస్ నా సామ రక్షస్సు గుణాయ కల్పతే, సామ ఈజ్ నాట్ గోయింగ్ టు వర్క్ హియర్. నా దానం అర్థోపచితేషు యుజ్యతే అండ్ నో క్వశ్చన్ ఆఫ్ గివింగ్ ఎనీథింగ్ టు దెమ్ బికాస్ దీస్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ సో స్టింకింగ్లీ రిచ్, దే ఆర్ సో మైటిలీ రిచ్. దిస్ లంక వాస్ ది ఎంపైర్, ఇట్ వాస్ ద క్యాపిటల్ ఆఫ్ కుబేరా. కుబేరా ఈజ్ ద గాడ్ ఆఫ్ వెల్త్ అండ్ రావణ డిస్పోసెస్డ్ హిమ్, త్రూ హిమ్ అవే అండ్ దెన్ హీ టుక్ ది సే కింగ్డమ్ ఆఫ్ కుబేరా. సో దే ఆర్ సో స్టింకింగ్లీ రిచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీవేర్ దెర్ ఈస్ గోల్డ్, ఎవ్రీవేర్ దెర్ ఈస్ సో మచ్ ఆఫ్ వెల్త్. సో నా దానం అర్థోపచితేషు చేతే, దిస్ దానం ఈజ్ నాట్ గోయింగ్ టు హెల్ప్ హియర్. అండ్ దీస్ పీపుల్ హూ ఆర్ సో ప్రౌడ్ ఆఫ్ దేర్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్, బలదర్పిత జనా నా భేద సాధ్యా, దిస్ భేద ఆల్సో ఈజ్ నాట్ గోయింగ్ టు వర్క్ బికాస్ దిస్ ఫెలో ఈజ్ సచ్ ఏ రూత్లెస్ రూలర్ అండ్ నౌ దెర్ ఈస్ నో అదర్ వే ఎక్సెప్ట్ నా భేద సాధ్య బలదర్పిత జనా పరాక్రమస్వేవ మమేహ రోచతే. పరాక్రమ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ ద వ్యాలర్, దట్ ఈస్ దండోపాయ, దట్ ఈస్ ద ఓన్లీ థింగ్ సే దట్ అపియర్స్ టు బి ది సే స్ట్రాటజీ హియర్, దట్ ఈస్ ద ఓన్లీ స్ట్రాటజీ విచ్ ఈస్ లైక్లీ టు వర్క్ హియర్. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ హీ థింక్స్. దేర్ ఈస్ అ బిగ్ రీజనింగ్ అండ్ దెన్ హీ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు పికప్ ఎ ఫైట్ హీ బ్రేక్స్ దట్ తోరణం. అండ్ దెన్ వెన్ దట్ తోరణం ఈస్ బ్రోకన్ ఆల్ ద గాడ్స్ దే వేకప్, దే క్యారీ దట్ న్యూస్ టు రావణ. హీ ఇమీడియట్లీ సెండ్ సమ్ పీపుల్, హీ బీట్స్ దెమ్ అండ్ థ్రాషస్ దెమ్ అండ్ సెండ్స్ దెమ్ అవే, సెండ్ సమ్ మోర్ పీపుల్ అగైన్, హనుమాన్ థ్రాషస్ దెమ్ ఆల్సో. అండ్ దెన్ అనదర్ మైటీ వారియర్ కాల్డ్ అక్ష, హూ ఈజ్ ది సన్ ఆఫ్ వన్ యంగ్ సన్ ఆఫ్ సే రావణ, దట్ ఫెలో కమ్స్ And then this Hanuman, he thrashes him, and then that fellow, he collapses. So, Pancha Senagragan, then what happens? Pancha Senagragan Hatva, Senagragaha, five chieftains, they come. Senagragaha, Senagragaha means this chieftains of the army. So, those people, they come, chiefs of army. And then Sapta Mantrisutanapi, and then seven sons of these ministers. Then Shuram Akshancha Nishpishya, this Aksha was also, he was Nishpishya means he was just made some sort of mincemeat. And then Grahanam Samupagamatu, at last what happened, Indrajit came, and then he used one mighty astra called Brahmastra. And then Brahmastra is that is the weapon of Brahma, to which he has to show respect. So, in order to show respect, he gets caught. Grahanam Samupagata means he got captured by Brahmastra. That has its effect on him only for a brief time, and then he gets released. He knows it, but then he wants to see Ravana. What is this Ravana? How he say of what strength he is? What exactly is his court? What exactly is his kingdom like? He wants to see. So, he gets caught. Then, Astrenon muktamatmanam nyatva paitamahadvarat marshayan rakshasan viro yantrinastan yadruchaya. So then he knows, Astrena unmuktam atmanam nyatva, he knows that he has been released from that Brahmastra. Unmukta means he has been released from that, weapon. Paitamahadvarat, because of the boon given by Pitamaha. Pitamaha means Brahma, Lord Brahma, he had given him a boon. Okay, you will be caught by my astra, only to show respect to my astra, and after some time you will be freed. But still, in addition to say tying them with that Brahmastra, these Rakshasas, they also tied him with lot many ropes. They were pulling him, and then they were trying to, after the man was got caught, in all anger somebody was punching, and somebody was knocking, and somebody was poking some stick and doing all silly things. So, Marshayan Rakshasan Viraha. So, he was tolerating all that. Hanuman was pleasantly tolerating all that. Yantrinaha, Yantrinastan Yadruchaya. Yadruchaya means willingly. Willingly, he was just tolerating all those fellows who were trying to control him. Yantrinaha means those who were trying to niyantrana, the controlling. They were trying to control him. Then thereafter, he goes to Ravana's court, and then in Ravana's court, there is a long discussion. So, he conveys the message of Rama, don't have a fight with Rama, etc. And then initially Ravana orders him to be killed, and thereafter on the advice of Vibhishana, it is not proper to kill a messenger. Then they want to set fire to the tail of Hanuman, and in that same bound condition, so his tail was set fire to. And then taking advantage of that, he goes, jumps from house to house, and then sets fire to the entire city. Tato dagdhva purim lankam. He set fire to the entire purim lanka. Rute sitam cha maithilim. Excluding just that particular corner where Sita was there in that Ashokavana. Excluding that Ashokavana, he set fire to the whole city. And then Ramaya priyamakhyatum punarayan mahakapihi. In order to tell the good news to Rama, he just flew back to where Rama was there. So bhigamya mahatmanam krutva ramam pradakshinam nyaveda yadame yatma drushta siteti tatvatah. So bhigamya mahatmanam, so he came back, he reached Rama, krutva ramam pradakshinam, he circumambulated, he went round Rama, because in olden days this was the practice. I was telling you, even earlier we saw Rama, while taking leave of his mother, he goes round. Taking leave of his father, he does some circumambulation. Like we go to temples, we do what is called pradakshinam. Dakshina means right, vama is left. Dakshina, pradakshinam means we keep the god to our right, god or whoever is if the parents are there, whoever it is. Suppose you go to a temple and the temple is on your right side while you are moving. So that is why it is called pradakshinam. Because dakshinam is the right. English word is dexterous. Dexter is right. Dexter and dakshina, they are related words. So, when you go round in a clockwise direction and not anti-clockwise direction, clockwise direction. So, that is what is called pradakshinam. Nyavedayadameyatma drushta siteti tatvataha. Then here again you see the way Hanuman conveys the message. When he just goes to Rama, straight away he says, drushta sita. Sita has been seen. So that is it. So instead of saying, okay, we went there, we went south in the southern direction, we saw all those kingdoms and then we searched all those caves. And then when we were there, sitting on the shore of ocean, then Sampati came. Instead of telling all that, he straight away conveys drushta sita. So in Valmiki, you find this style. Valmiki is a so straightforward style, very conversational. We see that highly dramatic style. In fact, it is almost like picturization. Nowadays, we use the word called picturization. So it is almost like script writing. Valmiki writes. So drushta sita iti tatvatah, a very very quick message. And later he gives the details. Then what happens? Then all those people, they collect the army. Tata sugriva sahito gatva tiram mahodadhehe samudram kshobhayamasa sharair aditya sannibhaihi. Then we have this episode called Rama and all this mighty army comes to the ocean, and they do not know how to cross the ocean. And then Rama requests the mighty ocean to give some way. But then it doesn't happen. So he shoots some arrows, and the lord of the sea, he presents before him, and then he gives an advice. Okay, there is one engineer in your team. His name is Nala. Let that Nala build a Varathi. So this Rama Setu, which we now talk about and about which there is a controversy. We do not know whether Rama Setu is built by Nala. According to Ramayana, it was something which was built by Rama. Of course, Rama means Rama asked Nala to build that thing, and then all these huge those primates, they all started and then they built that bridge. But of course, we are not very sure. The British people, they gave a different name. The British, when they came to India, they changed its name, and then they said it is Adam's Bridge. So what we call Rama Setu, they renamed it as Adam's Bridge. So if you see the world map, if you see the the atlas of published by British people or any atlas, you find it as Adam's Bridge. So this is the bridge called Rama Setu. So tata sugriva sahito, then darshayamasa chatmanam samudras saritampatihi. Samudraha, this lord of the ocean, he presented himself before Rama. Samudra vachanach seiva nalam setu makarayatu. He got the bridge constructed by Nala. Then tena gatva purim lankam hatva ravana mahave. Of course, all the details are not mentioned here. Very very briefly he is saying, tena gatva purim lankam, by that passage, by that bridge, they all went to Lanka. Hatva ravana mahave, in that huge battle, in that mighty battle, he killed Ravana. And Rama Sitam anuprapya param vridam upagamat. He got back Sita. When Sita approached, param vridam upagamat. Vrida means a sense of shame. Why should Rama feel a sense of shame? That is again a very 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 captivating, very pensive moment there we see in Ramayana. Because at that time Valmiki uses certain words there. Harsho dainyancha roshascha trayam raghavamavishat. So there is a mixed feeling there. On one hand, there is harsha. Harsha means happiness. On one hand, Rama is happy that Sita is back. Dainyam is total helplessness and misery. You see, this lady who is the daughter of a mighty king, she suffered a lot like this. So she was just feeling great pity and then feeling such great helplessness. Rosha, that anger that she has been captivated by this fellow called Ravana. So all these things, there is such a mixed feeling there which Valmiki describes. And also it is also the vrida is that sense of shame, as I was saying. Why? Because how to take her back? Because Rama may be knowing that Sita is a pure woman, but then she was there under the captivity of an enemy. She was a captive of the enemy for about an year. And if she is taken back, what will people think? Because he has to account for, or rather he has to take into consideration the people's opinion. Because Rama, we have been seeing right from the beginning, he has to take the people's opinion. So that is how, that is the reason why he was, say, feeling a sense of shame. Then tam uvacha tato ramah parusham jana samsadi. So in the presence of all people, he spoke rather rudely. Parusham, parusham means rudely, in a rather hurting manner. Sita also gives him a dose there. Why do you speak like this? You are talking like an ordinary man. Prakrutah prakrutamiva kimmam asadrusham vakyam idrusham shrotradarunam ruksham shravayase veera prakrutah prakrutamiva. She says, ruksham, ruksha is rude. You are talking in a very rude manner, like an uncultured man. Prakrutah, prakrutah means uncultured man. Prakrutamiva, to his uncultured wife. You are talking like an uncultured man. Why do you speak like that? So Sita also now and then she gives some doses, because she is also a very righteous woman. So then amrushyamana sa Sita, amrushyamana means unable to tolerate that. And then she says vivesha jvalanam sati, vivesha jvalanam. She immediately creates fire. She asks Lakshmana to create fire. Rama keeps quiet, he doesn't say anything. Sita says, she asks Lakshmana, create fire, and then she gets into the fire. At that time, of course, fire god, that Agni, appears, and he tells. So all this passage, of course, it is basically to tell us that there is one point in jurisprudence, that is, justice should not only be done but appear to have been done. That is one statement in jurisprudence. So here also Rama may be knowing that this lady is virtuous, but then how do all people know? So that is a very delicate point. It is very easy to ridicule. It is very easy to ridicule Rama. It is very easy to say that Rama was a male chauvinist, Rama punished his wife, etc., etc. But then it is not easy to visualize what a pious life, what a fire like Agnikalpanam, we heard a word called Agnikalpanam, what a fire like, what such a pious, very austere life people lived, what a pure life the people lived, we do not know, because we have so deviated from dharma, we are so far away. Nowadays the value system has so changed that we can't appreciate. So this is what we see, that justice has to be, it should also seem to be done. So that is what we see in this particular passage. We will continue in the next episode. Harihi Om Tat Sat.